Hello, I'm Graham Horton, and welcome to today's product review, which is for a wireless microphone with dual transmitter and single receiver, and it's the new Wavo Air from Joby. Now, Joby are part of the Vitech group, and Vitech are well known for their camera accessories and professional gear, so from a good stable comes this product. So, first of all, a full disclaimer, I was sent this to review for you free of charge. But as all my reviews are independent, you'll get to hear about the good points and the bad points about this microphone without any bias at all. So let's have a look at what you get for this at the asking price of £219 in the UK. So you can see here the attractive packaging that the Wavo Air comes in. It's a nice box which is quite sturdy and will protect it if you're moving it around. So, right, nice glossy pictures. If you look at the side of the unit, you'll see a picture of the transmitter. The transmitter with its plus and minus keys to increase the output. On the other side, you'll see the new fixings for their mounting. So this is a bayonet mount, which you can attach various mounting fixtures. On the side are the various technical specifications of the product. And on the back of the unit, you'll find the complete list of packaging content. So we've got the one receiver and the two transmitters. To go with the transmitters, we've got two wind shields which will fit over the top of these, get two lavalier microphones, the respective connecting cables, TRRS to TRRS for your camera and TRRS to TRRS for your smartphone. Obviously, you'll need to use the respective adapter for USB-C or lightning type phones. You also get three mounting options, a belt clip, a cold shoe mount and a magnetic mount with a pendant, which I'll show you later in the video. You also get three USB-A to USB-C charging leads. So everything is contained within the package, so you don't need to go out and buy anything else. Everything here is all that you need. Now the question is, why would you want to use a wireless microphone system when you can use a directly wired lavalier mic to your camera or one of these small shotgun mics on the camera? Well, the answer is getting the audio perfect. So you want to get the microphone as close to the talent voice as you possibly can. And that's quite difficult sometimes with an on-camera microphone if the talent is moving around. So a lavalier microphone or one of these mics that you can clip onto your shirt is an ideal solution. Now, if you don't mind those mics being in view, that's fine. Otherwise, you can use a lavalier mic and hide that on your talent under the shirt collar, inside the fabric of the clothing, or even in a hat or some spectacles. So you can hide the lavalier mic away from view. Now, most people look when they're purchasing a wireless mic for the distance it will work, up to say 80 meters, and how cheap it is. So the two conflicts of interest there. One is the distance, which I guess you're never going to be using a microphone at that distance. You'd be just a speck on the landscape. So ideally, you'll be using this at up to sort of 20 feet. So any one of the wireless microphones that you can probably buy, and I've got an array of them here on the table, will operate at 20 feet. And even if you turn your back so the transmitter is shielded from the receiver, you shouldn't get wireless dropouts, which you will get if you extend the distance of the transmitter to the receiver. So if you are expecting to use this at 50 meters and you turn your back, you'll lose the RF signal and you'll lose the audio. There's also the risk of interference with these 2.4 gigahertz frequencies. If you use it indoors, a lot of appliances use 2.4 gigahertz, your microwave, your router, any other wireless equipment, your mobile phone, all of those can provide interference, which can end up on your audio. And if it's an important recording, maybe that will be destroyed because you've got this interference. Typically, mobile phones will give you this pulsing audio effect in the background. I've had that several times on my videos where I forgot to put the phones onto airplane mode. So, enough of that speak. Let's have a look at what you get for your £219 or $219 in the States. So, we'll unbox the product. And the box itself has a magnetic catch on the lid, so it keeps it closed. If we open that up, you can see the entire contents of this box. We've got the usual beginner's guide to setting up the transmitter and the receiver. And now the important parts the receiver and the two transmitters. And here we have part of the mounting system. So we've got the cold shoe mount, we've got the belt clip, we've got a clip here which would attach to the original gorilla pod, so you could clip that to the leg of the gorilla pod, and we've got this magnetic mount here which goes with the pendant. If we look in the lower compartment of this box, first of all, see we've got a pin here which is used to reset the system if you lose the pairing. So that is almost like a phone SIM card extractor, just to enable you to push the reset button within the receiver. In this compartment you can see we've got that pendant which has got a magnet in it, which is used to attach your transmitter to if you wanted to use this around your neck, and I'll show you that later. We've also got the two included lavalier microphones. They're basic lavalier microphones, but what I do like about them is the fact that the foam windshield has a plastic liner. A lot of these foam windshields, it's difficult to get the cover back on if you take it off, but these are much easier to fit. Nice strong metal clip, so it's not likely to break, like some of the plastic ones. So a nice metal clip. Gold plated connector, so again, low interference risk. We've got a belt clip which allows you to use the transmitter on your belt or shirt, or you can put it in your top pocket, whichever, but it's the bayonet mount system, which I'll demonstrate again in a moment. We have the two windshield for the microphone, very reminiscent of the original Rode Go system with the two tabs. These two plastic tabs on the windmuff will fit into the two slots on the top of the microphone and will give quite a firm grip, not unlike the original Wireless Go, which would fall off and I lost the windmuffs in quick succession. So a much sturdier fix for the transmitters. You also get the two cables, the TRS to TRS and TRS to TRRS. In the other compartment we've got the USB-A to USB-C charging lead, so all is included with the kit, enough to get you going straight out of the box. So let's have a look at the component parts of the system and I'll go over the features of each of the units. So let's have a look at the transmitter first of all. We've got a button on the front which is the power on off button. You press and hold that to turn on the transmitter. You may notice here we've got a blue light which is an indication of the volume that you've got the transmitter set at. You can vary the volume from 0 to 30 dB in 5 dB steps, and you use the plus key or the minus key to adjust that. There is another small blue LED, you might be able to just see that flashing, which is the indication of the pairing between the transmitter and the receiver. And there's also a small LED here which is red, which will illuminate when the battery level falls to about 90 minutes worth of recording time left. So if this lights up during production, you know you need to be changing the transmitter or powering up another one. There is also a green light at the top of here which illuminates when you're charging the unit. So it will be green while it's been charged and then it will go out when it's fully charged. On the side of the unit we've got a 3.5mm input which is for the external lavalier mic, or in fact you could use a shotgun mic if you wanted to rather than the lavalier microphone on your talent. So you can use something like the Rode Video Micro or any of the other electret condenser microphones, they will work fine with this product. We've got the USB-C charging port, again standard charging for this device, so with the supplied USB-A to USB-C you can charge this from power banks. On the other side we've got the plus and minus to allow you to change the volume of the output. On top of the unit we've got our condenser microphone with the two holes here to allow you to fix that windmuff. So I'm a directional microphone, so it doesn't matter how you orientate this, you will still get good pickup. And on the back of the unit you can see this new bayonet system which allows you to fit the various mounting options for the transmitter or the receiver. So if this was a transmitter and you wanted to put it onto your trouser belt, if you wanted to use the lavalier microphone, then you just install that, turn it around to clip, and now you've got the system ready to clip onto your trouser belt, shirt collar or shirt, wherever. There's also supplied a magnetic piece here, which again will go into the bayonet mount system. Use a coin to lock it in place. And now you can use this with the supplied pendant to put this around your neck. So the pendant has the Joby logo on the front of it, so that must face forward, otherwise the two magnets will repel each other and it won't hold. So fixing that around your neck, you can then attach the transmitter and it's in the right place for getting good audio from the transmitter. So if you wanted to wear that, that's fine. If you didn't want this on the outside to show the string of the pendant, then you could put this on the inside of your talent. I'm going to just drop that down inside, like so, and then use the magnet to hold it in place, and you don't have that pendant showing. So you've got the two options there, whether you want to use the pendant externally or use it discreetly. Now, these are very bright units, but you can see the red flash. Not to my personal taste, I prefer a completely black unit if I am going to have one inside, but Joby are known for their fun products, so I guess red is in that interest. If we now look at the receiver, a much simpler affair, again with a red flash stripe, again a power on off button, press once and hold it to turn it on. They immediately pair, and you can see the little blue light here which indicates we've got pairing between the receiver and the transmitter. And in the transmitter, that 1 second pulsing light now becomes once every 5 seconds, so you can tell the system has paired. Again, just the USB-C charging port and an indicator to tell you when you're charging. It lights up green and then goes out when it's fully charged. On the other side, we've got our output for TRS to TRS or TRS to TRRS via smartphone. There's a little hole which you'd use that reset pin. If you lost the pairing for any reason, it would actually do a factory reset and pair them up. Now, additionally, you get a coaching mount, which you can actually mount the receiver onto your mirrorless camera or other system. But notice on this, I've placed a small black dot. It means that I got the orientation right when I put the black dot to the sort of 10-2 position and then turn it and lock it in place. It's quite possible that if you didn't do that, you could put this into the wrong position, so it will fit in one of three positions, and now your coaching mount is in the wrong position to orientate this the right way on your camera. So I put that black dot on there. Maybe in future editions of this it could be dimpled or it could be marked, but that's the way I've remembered to install this on that device. So the now you can install this on your camera and use it conventionally on top of your camera. Additionally, I did say you have this other mount which allows you to fix this to a gorilla pod, and again you would need to get the orientation right so that it would clip onto the leg of the gorilla pod and then take the output to your camera. Now, at the moment to record the audio, I'm using another wireless transmission system. This one is the Holyland Lark 150. I'm using the transmitter and it's about 18 inches away from my face here, so it's just out of shot and picking up the audio. So that's a quality from the sort of semi-professional one without using a lavalier mic. It's just using the omnidirectional mic in the transmitter. Let's now connect the Joby system up and let's look at the audio quality from that and see what you can expect from this device. I can see now I've mounted the Joby transmitter onto that magnetic lapel on the inside of my shirt. We've got the receiver here connected to my camera via the TRS to TRS lead, and my level is set to give me about minus 10 dB, which is the standard that I use for my audio recording. So all you need to do with the receiver is to plug it into your camera and have done with it. There's nothing else needed. If we look at the transmitter, then if I use this other transmitter, as this is a dual transmitter system, if you turn on the power, you notice we've got the blue LED light. To increase the gain, you use the plus key to move it around in 5 dB steps. So the first quadrant is 5, and then one more click gives you 10. If you press it one more time, you illuminate the second quadrant, so that's now 15 dB. Press it one more time, again moves in to the fourth section, which is 20 dB. One more click puts it into 25 dB, and one more click takes you to 30 dB. So you've got plenty of gain with this particular device. If you want to mute it, then you have to turn the volume all the way until those blue lights disappear, like so. So that transmitter is now muted. Now that is a bit of a disadvantage, because you have to remember what the levels are when you set the device. It would be better if there was a little button on here, you could just hit mute and it would mute the transmitter, or a button on the receiver and you could mute both transmissions. So it does rely on you getting your level set correctly, and then remembering which dB state you're at. So normally two click is enough for me, which gives me 10 dB gain for giving me the minus 10 dB level on my system. So that's about right. Now this is a dual transmitter system, so I could put both of these here, and the system is combining both of those left and right tracks, if you like, into one mono signal. Now that could be a showstopper for some people, because sometimes your talent voice increases on one channel and you need to reduce it in post-production. But because the two channels are combined together, there's no way you can separate the left and right channel to adjust the volume of each. More of the professional units like the Lark 150 or the Rode Wireless Go 2, you can actually separate the channels and have a true stereo signal, left and right channel. And if your talent voice increases on one or the other, or you get interference on the other channel, then you can reduce it in post and you're clear. But with this system, both left and right are combined into one mono signal to come out to the camera. So be aware that if you were expecting left and right being able to independently adjust the volume for each channel, I'm afraid that's not the case with this particular setup. Again, both of the transmitters pair immediately with the receiver, so if you are using it for two-person interviews, both will be paired simultaneously, so no problem with the dropouts. We've now heard the audio quality from the inbuilt omnidirectional microphone of the transmitter. I'm going to connect up the supplied lavalier microphone so we can hear the quality from that. So you can now see that I've attached the supplied lavalier microphone here to my shirt, but the right placement, 6 inches below your mouth, to give you the right audio quality. You can see the transmitter here. I've plugged the TRS connection into the mic input socket, so you're hearing now the audio from the supplied lavalier microphone. With these systems, it really doesn't matter what sort of lavalier microphone you attach. The compression in these systems tends to overcome any of the finer points that you get with a more expensive microphone. So it's not worth putting a more expensive microphone, in my opinion, on these cheaper wireless systems. If you get to the more expensive ones, then a lavalier microphone with a higher quality does pay dividend. But for the smaller systems, for amateur production, I guess it's not going to be worth the money to buy a more expensive lav mic. You can also use one of these shotgun mics, and again I'll use the Rode Video Micro and give you a demonstration of the audio you can get from the Rode Video Micro into this particular transmitter. We can see there on the desk I've got my Rode Video Micro plugged into the Joby Wavo Air transmitter. It's around about a foot away from my face, which is the normal placement, and I've set the levels again to give minus 10. You can see the connection between the transmitter and the microphone on the desk here. So that's the audio quality from one of these short shotgun mics, which are quite common on Amazon, etc. So we've now heard the audio quality of the internal omnidirectional microphone of this Joby Wavo Air system and the supplied lavalier microphone, so you can judge for yourself the audio quality. It's all unprocessed. I'm not going to add any compression, expansion and other equalization parameters. You're hearing the raw audio from this device. Everyone's take on the final production will vary. Everyone's ears are different, and the device you're listening to will also play an effect on the audio quality. If you're listening to it on high level speakers, you'll probably find the system is lacking. If you're listening to it on a smartphone or a tablet or a computer, then you probably find the audio quality is quite good without any equalization, as these tend to have quite a bit of compression in them to reduce the overall dynamic range, if you like, of the audio. If there are any weaknesses of the system, I would say the new included bayonet mount system is to me, a little bit of an overkill. And for the cold shoe mount, remember I put a dot on there to indicate which way around to attach this to the receiver. If there'd been a 1/4-20 threaded mount in there, a brass mount, you'd be able to mount this onto a tripod or other parts of your camera rig. It is available with a threaded mount as part of an additional mounting kit, but you're going to be paying £45 for that mounting kit. So it could have been included with that standard cold shoe mount at no extra cost. Very easy to fit that. And in fact, I might fit one in here myself after this production. So that would be my first weakness. The second one is the belt clips. Again, if they'd been cut down to the size that would fit onto your cold shoe, then again you could be able to mount this onto the receiver and clip this onto the top of the camera as an additional way of mounting. So again, a missed opportunity for that clip. Now, one of the other problems I've got is with the indication of the volume setting of the transmitter. You've got the three quadrants which give you the indication of 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 or 30 dB gain, but within each quadrant you've got 5 or 10, 15 or 20, 25 or 30. So which are you actually set at? It's important if you muted that microphone to go back to the original setting. So I would like to have seen some sort of display, a little LCD display, to give me that indication. A lot of these other units that I've had on the desk have some LCD display which shows you the volume. So at this price point for £219, I think I would have expected a little more. But apart from that, the fact that you can get up to 30 dB gain gives you the opportunity to use it with cameras where you've got a lower sensitivity input. So it is a good transmitter receiver pack for that purpose. Okay, I'm going to take this unit outside and we'll do a short range test up to about 40 feet, which is the furthest distance I would ever consider using a wireless transmission system outside. And we'll see if we get any dropouts if I turn my back on the transmitter to block that line of sight. Another problem I've just come across with the system is the supplied smartphone cable. Now, obviously this has been produced for Joby by some external manufacturer, but obviously the quality control isn't that good because this particular plug, the length of the cover here on the plug is too long. It doesn't expose the ring sleeve. It doesn't expose that sleeve, so it won't engage with any of the adapters for your phones. It doesn't click in place. If you look at a proper plug, you notice that the sleeve is much longer, so about twice that distance, and this just plug in and latches like so. So quality control issue here with the lead. So if you were purchasing this, you'd be a bit disappointed that you can't use it. So a little bit of QC issue for Joby to look at there. I've now brought the Joby Wavo Air system outside. It's connected to my Galaxy S22 Ultra and we're at a distance of about 5 feet away from the camera. So that's the distance that I would normally use this in a two camera interview sort of situation. But I'm going to go to the back of the garden, which is about 30 feet away, just to see if we get any dropouts from the system. So I'll move over there with my back facing the camera. So we should have the line of sight being blocked by my body. So under normal circumstances we wouldn't want that to drop out between 10 and 20 feet. It may drop out at 30 feet. Let's see what happens. So here we are walking away from the camera and we're now about 15 feet, about 20 feet, 25 feet and 30 feet. So that's line of sight blocked. By turning around, we should get a good RF signal between the transmitter and receiver, so the pair should work very well. So let's come back to the camera and just check that out. Well, I think you could see from that test, we didn't get any RF dropouts at a distance of up to 35 feet. So under normal circumstances, I think this unit would be ideal if you're going to have talent, which is changing position, blocking the line of sight between the transmitter and receiver. Everything should be fine at that distance. So that's my review of the Wavo Air system. At £219, you are getting that dual transmitter single receiver pack, but I think it might appeal to more users if it was available as a single transmitter and single receiver as an entryway into getting better audio for your video productions. It is into a marketplace which is now saturated with these transmitter receiver packs, some offering more than what a job you're offering, and some offering much less. So it really is a case of what you need against your budget. Comparing it to something like the Rode GO2, where you aren't supplied with lavalier microphones, this does seem an attractive price. But if you look at the Godox system, which is £175, you are getting a little bit more in terms of the functionality of the unit than you are with a Joby. So it's horses for courses, and I'll let you decide on what really you need. So that's it for the video. Thanks very much for watching. Please do take care, and I hope to see you all very, very soon. Goodbye for now.